because when lockdown came, these women went back in their homes with the little money that everyone had in their pocket. Feeding the homes had to continue.
Accessing affordable finance is one of the recurring challenges businesses globally continue to struggle with. The situation has for the last 20 months been worsened by the COVID-19 pandemic that affected several businesses, especially women-owned ones, whose capital was significantly wiped away.
We celebrate the resilience in our women, that even after all these several lockdowns and many months of not working, they have been able to rethink and look at how they can do business better. There are those who have embraced technology.
At its annual Women in Business Leaders Conference held in Kampala, the Uganda Women Entrepreneurs Association prioritized aspects that can help business women bounce back from the effects of COVID-19. Some of these included access to finance and regional markets, acceleration of digital technology, and opportunities in public procurement.
We are helped to put our documentation in order so that we are able to be fit for the financial opportunity that is present for us. Many of us women are probably not ready when it comes to documentation-wise.
Additionally, at least 30% of public procurement has been ring-fenced for marginalized groups such as women, youth, and the disabled.
But now we are monetizing it. We are looking at, in terms of value, what is the value of the budget that should be allocated to particular groups of people.
According to the Public Procurement and Disposal of Public Assets Authority, the regulations that stipulate exactly how much of public procurement is reserved for groups like women are expected to be completed by March next year. This shall be followed by sensitization of different stakeholders and how to implement the regulations. This story was compiled by Benon Ojiambo for the news in Kampala.